Hey guys, the question is, Dozier Company produced and sold 1,000 units during its first month of operation. It reported the following cost and expenses for the month. Here is the data. You can find the whole data in the description box here. With respect to cost classification for preparing financial statements, what is the total product cost and total period cost? So here, first, we have to calculate total product cost. So total product cost include direct material, direct labor, and variable manufacturing overhead. Total manufacturing overhead, not variable, fixed and variable both. So here direct materials is $69,000. And direct labor $35,000, and total manufacturing overhead is $43,000. So our total will be equal to 69,35 plus 43, $147,000. So total product cost is equal to $147,000. Now the B point is, what is the total period cost? So total period cost is equal to total selling expenses and total administrative expenses. Here total selling expenses, total selling expenses 30,000, and administrative expenses $29,000. So our total period cost is equal to 13 plus 29, $59,000. Now the second point is, second point is, what is the total direct manufacturing cost? So total direct manufacturing cost. Here first of all, direct material and direct labor. Direct material is of 69,000 and direct labor is of $35,000. So our total direct manufacturing cost is equal to 69 plus 35,000, $104,000. Now we will calculate what is the total indirect manufacturing cost. So our B point is, total indirect manufacturing cost here. So here we will include variable manufacturing overhead and fixed manufacturing overhead, or we can say total manufacturing overhead, which is $43,000. Total manufacturing overhead, which is $43,000, or we can say fixed manufacturing overhead and variable manufacturing overhead. Now the third point is, what is the total manufacturing cost? So here we will calculate total manufacturing cost. So total manufacturing cost will include direct material, direct labor, and total manufacturing overhead. So it is our same total manufacturing cost, or we can say total product cost, which is $147,000. Now, the B point is, what is the total non-manufacturing cost? Total non-manufacturing cost. Here, total non-manufacturing cost is equal to total period cost, which is total period cost, or we can say total manufacturing cost are same. So it is about $59,000. Here total manufacturing cost and total product cost are same. So we can say total manufacturing cost. Now the C point is the total conversion cost and prime cost. So total conversion cost and prime cost is equal to, here conversion cost is direct labor and total manufacturing overhead. Total manufacturing overhead. Direct labor is of $35,000. So our total conversion cost is equal to 35 plus 43, $78,000. Now our prime cost is direct material and direct labor. So it will be is equal to direct material, direct labor. So it is equal to total prime cost 69 plus $35,000. Now the fourth point is total variable and manufacturing cost. Total variable and manufacturing cost. So here first of all variable cost, here direct material and direct labor and variable manufacturing overhead. Sorry, direct labor and variable manufacturing overhead. Variable manufacturing overhead is of $15,000. So our total variable cost is equal to 69 plus 35 plus 15, $119,000. Now total variable manufacturing cost. Now the second point is total fixed cost. So here fixed manufacturing overhead, fixed selling expenses, fixed manufacturing overhead, fixed selling expenses and fixed administrative expenses. So our total fixed cost. So our fixed manufacturing overhead $28,000. Fixed selling expenses $18,000. And fixed administrative expenses $25,000. So total fixed cost will be 28 plus 18 plus 25, $71,000. Now we will calculate variable cost per unit produced and sold. Variable cost per unit produced and sold. So variable cost per unit produced and sold . First of all, we will take direct material, direct labor and variable manufacturing overhead. Then it will include variable selling expenses, variable selling expenses $12,000, and variable administrative expenses . So it is equal to variable administrative expenses is equal to $4,000. So our total variable cost, it is equal to sum of this value, $135,000. Now number of units produced, and sold 1000. So our variable cost per unit produced and sold is equal to $135,000 divided by 1000 unit. So it is equal to $135 per unit. The fifth point is, if Dozier had produced 1001 units instead of 1000 units, how much incremental manufacturing cost would it have incurred to make the additional unit? So here, first we will take fifth point is incremental manufacturing cost. Manufacturing cost. So first of all, we will take direct material, direct labor and variable manufacturing overhead. Here total incremental cost will be, incremental cost is equal to sum of this value, 6935 plus 15. After that we will take number of units produced and sold, 1000. So incremental cost per unit per unit produced and sold. So here 119,000 divided by 1000 units, so it is equal to $119 per unit. So here are my solutions. In case any doubt, you can ask me through comment box. And if you find my solution helpful, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel.